بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وآله وصحبه من اهتدى بهداه أما بعد السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته and welcome to the second part of tonight's دورة and the 10th chapter and we should at least I think be putting the pedal to the metal as they say and try to talk a little bit faster because our time is limited. Tomorrow is our last day. But no worry, inshallah, hopefully we're on track. We still have 47 more chapters. we're doing well, don't worry. Bismillah.
Chapter number 10, the earnings of a person and his manual labor. Hadith number 993. Narrated Al-Miqdam radiallahu anhu, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, nobody has ever eaten a better meal than that which one has earned by working with one's own hands. The Prophet of Allah, Dawood alayhi salam, used to eat from the earnings of his manual labor.
So this hadith, a lot of the scholars considered it to be indicating to the virtue of working with your own hands as a craft. So whether you, what was the craft of Prophet Dawood?
Iron
Man is a movie.
Iron Bobby.
He was a blacksmith.
Blacksmith
is the more appropriate word for that. So he was a blacksmith. Prophet Nuh was a carpenter and Prophet Musa, a shepherd, our Prophet also worked in, as a shepherd and as a businessman trading. So some scholars made this hadith only to highlight the virtues of working with your own hand as a craft. However, the hadith is more general. So even trading is earning from your own hands. Teaching, an engineer, a doctor, all of these, not necessarily you have to have labor. And someone says, I can be a dentist. No. It's best you do something like a goldsmith or sweeping the floors in order to have it pure. No. Any work that you work and actually put effort into it, including trade, including farming, that would be similar to the hadith. Now, what other sources that one can earn other than such jobs?
Service.
Service is also working with your own hands.
Investing
is working with your own hand.
Fashionista
is working with your own body. What else?
Farming
is working with your hand, definitely.
Teaching
is working with your hand. I'm coming and teaching you.
Counseling.
See, you're limiting your thoughts to what you do. There are incomes that you don't do, such as gifts. So I can sit home and people give me gifts. I can earn through inheritance. My father died and he left me a fortune, so I'm eating from it. Is this halal or haram? It's halal, but the best way of earning is something that you do. Why? Because it prevents you from begging people and asking people. And scholars differed whether farming is better or trade. And I am inclined to farming. Why? Because it has a lot of reliance on Allah. A merchant buys the goods, he may sell it with a profit, he may break even, he may sell it with little loss. A farmer, make it or break it. He does his work and waits for 5 months, 6 months, ya Rab. Maybe floods can come, maybe drought, maybe not pesticides are not used, and a lot of diseases come, and you never know. So there is a lot of reliance on Allah Azza wa Jalla in farming, a lot. But it's a difference of opinion. So in this same chapter, you know, this hadith, this book is a mukhtasar, which is summarized or concise, or the short version of Sahih al-Bukhari. In the same chapter, there are a number of hadiths. One of them, the Prophet said, for you to go and chop for firewood and come and sell it, better than you ask people whether they give you or not. So this is one of the forms of income, to ask people to beg. So no, work, do whatever it needs, but don't beg people. The second hadith, when Abu Bakr, may Allah be pleased with him, became the Khalifa, he went to the market to trade. Umar and Abu Ubaidah stopped him. Said, hey, where are you going? He said, I'm going to put food on the table. What I'm going to do? Said, no, you're a Khalifa. You can't go to the souk. This is 5 dinars. No, this is 6. We bargain and you make a business deal. So he says that my people, Abu Bakr says, may Allah be pleased with you, my people know that my craft would not be short from feeding my family. My craft being a merchant and a businessman. Have I not been engaged in ruling the Muslims and running their affairs? Then in this case, I have to refrain from trade, and me and my family would eat from the treasury of the Muslims. Umar and Abu Ubaidah gave him 1/2 a sheep per day. This is his wages. The value of 1/2 a sheep per day. This is a Muslim ruler, Khalifa. And he accepted that and he lived upon that.